rear. We have the twin turbo V6. We have an electric motor directly attached to the crankshaft output, and that all the power is flowing down to the road through a brand new 9-speed DCT. If you look in the spine of the vehicle, the intelligent power unit houses the battery, the lithium-ion battery that's behind the driver passenger seat on the cold side of the cabin. The power drive electronics are in the center console down low. And then up front, you have the twin motor unit. So let's start with some of the elements and step through them. Twin turbocharged V6. Double overhead cam, electric wastegate for quick response, intake and exhaust, variable timing control, not only direct injected but port injected, high compression ratio. A lot of work to make this engine compact down low in the chassis, 75 degree bank angle, very compact swing arm type valve train, the plasma thermal spray on the sleeve for good heat transfer. Fundamental combustion performance and a dry cell. Maximum power 500 horsepower between 65 and 7500 RPM. Very broad torque, 406 foot pounds from the engine itself across a wide range, 2000 and above. The rear electric motor, the direct drive motor, is directly on the crankshaft. It's there to immediately fill in the torque to eliminate any sense of turbo lag and to directly assist your throttle demands. And again, this is flowing out to the rear axle. So this is what's happening at the rear axle. And peak torque is available from 500 RPM, essentially all the time. And the torque flows out through the 9-speed DCT. First gear is a launch gear, ninth gear is a cruising gear, and sandwiched in between is a very close ratio 7-speed gearbox. We do arrange the gear sets in parallel rather than putting them out the rear, so we're trying to bring the mass closer to the driver. And then if we move forward to the front, the twin motor unit in the front. So this is some people say through the road, active all-wheel drive, so the power is flowing through the road with no prop shaft whatsoever. So independent motor, left and right, and that motor's output is multiplied by this double pinion gear mechanism, essentially a planetary gear mechanism. And peak torque available from zero. So if we stack them all up, you can see every time you accelerate, on the rear axle, the twin turbo V6 working together with the electric motor. And other people have this, but the icing on the cake is the additional force of the twin motor unit pulling all the time. Again, it's an active all-wheel drive system with a combined horsepower of 573 and a combined torque of 476 foot-pounds of torque. So if we turn that drive force into an acceleration G that you will feel in your body, of course there's amazing peak performance, but we really want to focus in on what's happening in the first half a second. So we think that immediate response, also it's very linear. So we do not feel the driveline force is difficult to control or access for the driver. And I think that will pay dividends not only on the track, but as you enjoy the open roads. Just pointing out a few technologies to introduce the kind of mechanical soundtrack into the cabin. The intake sound control, shown there in yellow or orange, directly goes into the intake manifold. There is a throttle control on that opening, so we can adjust that when you're adjusting the dynamic mode switch, and we introduce those sounds on both the driver and passenger side, the upper corners of the cabin. And then in green, the active exhaust valve. When that valve is open, the exhaust gases are flowing through all four exhaust pipes. When it is closed, it redirects or turns the exhaust gases through the silencers. So you can see the split silencer cans on either side. and it forces those exhaust gases to only exit out the outboard two exhaust pipes.